Hi everyone, welcome to Le Gourmet TV. So today I've got an action-packed, really busy day. I'm gonna leave the house early, I'm gonna come home late, I'm probably not gonna get a decent lunch, and when I do get home, I'm not really gonna wanna pull out my pots and pans and cook, so I'm gonna use a slow cooker. Absolutely no reason to write off the slow cooker. This is a tool in your kitchen that you can produce excellent meals from. And you can make it as difficult as you want, or in this case, I'm gonna make it dead simple because I really don't wanna spend a lot of time with it, but I still wanna pull that flavor out. So I've got just an array of very simple ingredients here that are gonna be able to build that flavor over the slow cooking time. Got a couple of pork chops and just very simply salt and pepper. Season them up, both sides. And throw these into the bottom of the cooker. Pretty simple so far. Now I've got some sauerkraut. You can use any brand of sauerkraut that you like. This is from a local deli. They make it in-house. It's absolutely incredible. I don't think I can make anything at home that even rivals this. So we throw that in on top of our pork chops. Just to cover the pork chops, and over the slow cooking time, that flavor is just gonna melt into the pork chops. Now you notice I did not brown the chops ahead of time. That's a way to really build flavor in a dish like this. I don't have time this morning, so I'm not gonna do it. If you really want to, brown them up before you put them in. You don't have to cook them, just get that crust on the outside. Now, in order to make up for that flavor loss, I'm gonna use some of my homemade bacon. This is bacon that I've cured at home and smoked. So that smoky flavor is really gonna work itself into the dish over the cooking time. I'm just gonna take the pieces that I've already chopped up, I'm gonna throw them into the pot on top of what's in there already. Then on top, just a little bit more pepper. And the last little bit is I'm just gonna put in a little bit of apple juice. Again, this apple juice is going to add just an extra layer of flavor. And you don't have to put much in because there's gonna be a lot of liquid come out of the sauerkraut. Pour that on, getting about 3/4 of an inch of liquid in the bottom of the pot. And I think for this recipe and the amount of ingredients that I'm using here, that's all you need. Now, I'm not gonna add any potatoes, but to this, you could add any vegetable that you want. You could throw in potatoes, you could throw in carrots, you could throw in a couple of onions, anything just to make it your own. You don't have to follow what I'm doing. Just kind of take this, embrace it, make it your own, find the flavors that you want. There are times when I throw mustard in here because I really like the flavor of mustard with all of this. You know, you could put in anything you want. Make it your own. So, on goes the lid. And I'm gonna set this. It has a setting called auto, so I can set it at auto, and I'm gonna let this go for, oh, I think I'll be home probably in about 7 hours. When I come home from work, I'll just dish this out. Maybe I'll boil up a potato and mash it just to have on the side, but for the most part, it's a meal in itself. So I guess I'll see you again in about 7 hours. So it's absolutely wonderful to come home to a house full of this smell after a hard day of work. And we're all ready to serve, so I've got some mashed potatoes on the plate. And pull out pork chop, keeping some of the sauerkraut and bacon on top. And the pork chop was so tender, it just completely fell apart. A couple extra pieces of bacon just to put on top. This is something that's hearty and it's going to warm your belly on a cool winter day. Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again soon.